Hello guys, we're back on the last cube. I'm on the laptop, so let's do this. Just getting myself comfortable, getting the mouse sorted out and the laptop sorted out on the table. A couple of a dodgy cube table on this. This is a hard one. I think it is.
Guested on more than 600 radio shows and written, produced, and appeared in numerous television shows and documentaries, including 3 2-hour specials for CBS, as well as the Ancient Mystery series, all devoted to understanding ancient religions and their pervasive influence on world affairs today.
Jordan, it's a pleasure having you on the broadcast.
Well, thank you very much.
Oh, it's no problem. It's funny how the universe works, because we had a great broadcast last week. I'm sure this week gave you plenty of time to think about even more stuff that you wanted to put on the broadcast, so I think it's all going to work out for the best. Let me ask you this. You just got back from the Vatican. How was that trip out there?
Well, it was very nice for me, but the Vatican, of course, is incredible. Kind of scary at times, but it was a beautiful trip to Switzerland, and I was there for a little bit of a section, and I liked it for that. But anyway, a lot of time I'm sure that I was getting very different feedback from your wife.
Okay. Yeah, we can give you a call right back. All right, is that better?
I think so.
Very good.
Anyway, the Vatican is an incredible place.
How does it? Oh, I can't get it now.
Take us on the journey.
I don't know how to do this one. It's hard for this, guys. Perfect. That took a little while.
Just need to Institution, you
which represents God. This is why those kings have a divine right of kings in Europe, a divine right of kings. What are you talking about, divine right? Who can control a divine right on the king? Well, it's the doctor who anoints kings in Europe to be kings and princes because they have a divine right, meaning the Pope speaks for God. And therefore, the Pope speaks for God, if he and my children have a divine right to rule, well, we can just as easily remove our divine right. So, once you see and once you accept that the Pope has absolute sovereign authority over all mankind, as the Book of Isaiah has said over and over in the documents, that the Pope has absolute sovereign control over all life on the earth, man, and animal, that the Pope, Jesus was given the earth by God, and what Jesus has brought here, so he needs someone to step in to own the earth, so he comes back, so that world is a vicar. And therefore, the Pope is not the vicar of Christ, he's staying in for Jesus. Because Jesus is not here, God has given the earth to Jesus, so he's been born of Christ. Lord, until Jesus comes back, the Pope Lord himself, own the earth and all life upon it. Because he has a divine right from his God to rule. So the Pope's basically our divine babysitter. And so the anyone who would step in for Messiah is a person who is a vicar. A vicar is what he stands in for. Well, the Pope is standing in for Jesus right now. So whatever he says the law is, that's what the law is. And whoever he anoints the king, that's God speaking. And so you can see where the corruption is in one of the British state statements that power corrupt and absolute power corrupt absolutely. Well, today all over Europe, everywhere, our churches are absolutely corrupt. America is probably the most corrupt of all of them.
Well, who's
and all of the governments in Europe are profoundly corrupt and corrupted systems of finance, money, political power, violence.
Hey, yo. Yeah, religion does not
product of this series in which you actually get the offspring of the original state on nature. And because the partnership movement was not happy with the way that Rome was running the world, it did not want to change the religion. And dropped the worship of Dagon and all the other children of the prince of Rome into religion. But the part of this world movement did not want to drop the rest. The rest of work. But it was a unit. The crowd loved it. So they didn't want to change and do anything spectacular and change the worship of Dagon. They just didn't like the way Rome was running. So they broke off and started a new of the old Roman religion called the Thomas Protection. It was a protection against the way Rome ran Europe. So today, even the Protestant churches of the world are worshiping Dagon, and the worship of this ancient god is everywhere. And this is why even being a fish guy, this is why on the back of Christian cars, you would see a fish symbol. We're told that that was a symbol of Christianity or the fish symbol. Well, the purpose of this movement was the symbol of Christianity because Christianity was the worship of Dagon or, in astrological terms, Pisces. Pisces was always a symbol of a fish or two fish. And all of the Catholic Church and all of the Protestant churches, every year you will see Jesus with two fish. And because Jesus, or the story of Jesus, was based on Dagon, the fish god, that represented the worship of Pisces, the fish.
Well, he said the cross would be the cause of great fishing. He said the cross was the local writing in two fish.
And two fish. The fish was the symbol of Pisces, the true fish. And in Luke 22:10 in the Bible, in Luke Testament, when Jesus is going to be commemorated what they call the Last Supper, the last meal, the Passover meal, the apostles asked Jesus, and this is a symbolic metaphor, the apostles asked Jesus, where are we going to go now that we're going to die? Now that you're going to leave us, where are we going to go? And we say, back, go into the city, and you will see a man with a water pitcher. A man carrying a water pitcher, go into the house of the man with the water pitcher. For anybody who knows the story of Jesus, the next sign after Pisces is Aquarius. Always symbolized by a man with a water pitcher. And so it was a symbolic killer with his son that suddenly comes up in the morning and brings life into the world. The son is in the age of Pisces on the Jesus. And now that Pisces is leaving the world, there's a new constellation coming on the earth. The moon is the age of Aquarius. So the sun now calls his 12 companies, the 12 apostles, which are actually the 12 months of the year or the 12 signs of the zodiac. And so the 12 signs of the zodiac, or the 12 followers of God's son, ask him, where are we to go? You're going to leave us now in the age of Pisces, which is this. Where are we going to go? This is the age of the city. So you can manage the water pitcher going to the house of the man with the water pitcher. Well, that's the house of the first. Well, I'm saying that the entire story of the New Testament is a metaphor. It's a symbolic story explaining the whole concept of the astrological story, which is far back as you can go in history. The most ancient story on the earth is called astrotheology. And all these people who have studied religion know, even the priests and the clergy, they know about astrotheology, about the beginning of Christianity, where it comes from. They know that. But they have a job to do. They can pay the prophets that their life depends on. They're in the organization. Just because they're working for spheres or general numbers, they're not necessarily being right to do it, because they're just not.
It's a good puzzle, this, guys. The Capitol Hill. I don't know what to do with this one. Excuse me. So stumped with this one. Let's clear all the way. Thank you. that had the
what to be afraid if we're cooking conventionally and on a fairly decent speed to box it at. So I have a lot of material that you can get right now that documents the stuff, especially about food capability, read about type-written manuscript on the very subject we're talking about now.
Can you bring me some of your research files, correct?
Yes, I have this network on a gun computer. I have six computers with that local application, incredible amount of material on all of them. This is one of the research files I have, which has 3.4 gigabytes, 161 folders, 5,080 items. That's just one folder, but and I've got more coming. That's about 5,000 documents and materials, research materials. So on the What's New on my website, CivicNetwork.com, a lot of stuff here directly is what we're talking about right now.
And support Jordan, ladies and gentlemen, because when we do this kind of thing, we don't get rich, we go broke. We go broke very fast. And Jordan has dedicated his life to bringing all of this knowledge. So, pick up a couple of DVDs. Not only are they a good watch, but you're supporting a very, very talented researcher.
I'm going to call it a day, guys. I've had enough. Take care.